And thank you much. All right. Now, I know you said that when it comes down to school issues, your hands are tied by the school board. But this next question, school bullying, has become a major problem. It has become a national issue. It has become a local issue. Clearly a problem. Would you support a county ordinance, though, that makes it a misdemeanor to bully children off school property in places like parks and sports fields? Ms. Jacobs, I'm going to start with you.
You know, I never like to answer a question without having done a little bit of research. My emotional initial reaction is, yeah, I would be in favor of anything that we can do to make bullying less acceptable. But I think more than just creating an ordinance, I think it's about a lot of education. We need to be talking to our kids, and we need to figure out how to talk to them in a way that they begin to understand how much hurt they're inflicting on each other. This is a really important issue. The other issue that I see at schools is a zero tolerance for any kind of violence. And I understand why that's important. But we are also, I'm afraid, teaching our children to stand back and not look out for each other. Somewhere there's a social conscience that we've got to work on teaching, not just the ABCs, not just math. We need to teach that social responsibility, that social conscience. And I think there's one, you know, you would think being in politics and raising four kids, teenagers, while you're in office would be a bad thing. But I've got to tell you, for my family, I think my children are better people because of the exposure that they had to more people, to more understanding, to more compassion, to volunteering at the Homeless Coalition. Those types of activities are good for our kids. When they have to do something for somebody else, not because they're going to get a trinket or a prize because they raised enough money for some fundraiser at school, but they do it because it's the right thing to do, and they get that gratification. What does it feel like to do something for somebody else? We're not giving that to our kids, and we need to give that to them. While we're trying to teach them not to bully, we also need to teach them how to love.
Mr. Siegel, what about you? What about some sort of law ordinance to try to prevent this off school grounds?
You know, again, I am very hesitant to pass any new laws, but I will tell you that school bullying has become such a terrible, terrible problem that if the school systems can't deal with it directly, then I would support it at the county level or the state level. It has gotten terribly out of hand. Discipline in the schools. I'm a product of the Orange County Public Schools. Unfortunately, to be honest with you, a lot of parents aren't doing their jobs, and they're thrust into the school systems, and the teachers are forced to have to become, I guess it's the old Latin, in loco parentis. They have to become the parents, and they have a million other things to do. I went to a seminar the other day, and I saw how the teachers have to struggle to get the class size amendment just right. They're spending all their times on these rules and regulations from the state and have little time left for instructional sort of things. So, again, a terrible problem, and if the schools can't address it, then the county and the state ought to.
Ms. Jacobs, would you like to add anything?
No, I think we're in agreement on that.